In our earlier video called Nalanda University, a Tamil word, we had established that the very name of Sikhs originated from a Tamil word called Sikkam, meaning head of hair or the tallest point. And even the name of their dream nation, Khalistan, had evolved from the goddess Kali of Tamil tradition, etc. Here we are presenting further proofs that Sikhs were Tamils earlier, and because of several invasions, their language got changed to the present one. This can be said of every native community of North India. But in the present video, we are focusing only on Sikhs. A baptized Sikh should possess 5 Ks called Kakas. These 5 Ks are 5 articles of Sikh faith, whose names start with the letter K. These articles are Kachera, Kara, Kipan, Kanga, Kesh. In this video, we established that of the names of the 5 articles, 4 are of Tamil origin. In this video, we shall take each object and describe its purpose and significance and then prove that the name is of Tamil origin. Kachera. It is a must undergarment of the baptized Sikh. Philosophically, Kachera is meant to remind a Sikh to be free from lust or greed. On the other hand, it is a combat-ready dress. A true Sikh should protect a hapless person, even if he is unknown to him, against any attack on him or her. For instance, if a woman is attacked for rape, or if a person is racially attacked, or if a person is looted of his possession, etc., in such occasions, the Sikh would protect the victim, and in the process, the Sikh might even put his own life in danger. In the process of protecting the victim, the Sikh might have to physically fight the attacker. In order to involve in the fight without hindrance, the Sikh should wear a comfortable combat undergarment shown in the figure. This undergarment is called Kachera. Origin of this name is a Tamil name called Kachai. When a Tamil engaged in a quick fight, he would be wearing his veti called dhoti as shown in the figure. This is called Kachai in Tamil. This is a quick combat dress of Tamils even today. We are presenting a visual to make the fact obvious. Kara. A baptized Sikh should wear a metal ring around his right wrist. The philosophical meaning of the same is to free one from entanglement. It also symbolizes continuity, as a ring has no beginning or end. On the other hand, it is a symbol of bravery, manliness, reminding the wearer to defend the truth. This is called Karavalai in Tamil. Here, Karam in Tamil means hand, especially forehand. Karavalai in Tamil means hand ring. Hence, Six Kara is a shortened form of Karavalai, which is a Tamil word. Kirpan. A baptized Sikh should wear a weapon called Kirpan around his waist. Its philosophical meaning is to cut through the untruth to find truth. Since Sikh is the protector of the hapless, he needs a fighting device, and that is what this knife-like object is. Since Sikhs are not an aggressive people, and they are defenders of freedom of an individual, this fighting device symbolizes that concept. Since it is not a dagger which inflicts a deep injury, this kirpan does less damage to the enemy, and its primary purpose is to warn him away from his evil intention. Hence, both philosophically and as a device of a definite utility, this particular device serves a just purpose. But our concern here is to find the word origin of Kirpan. We have said that the philosophical purpose of this defense device is symbolically mean to cut through the untruth to find truth. Hence, the meaning is tear, split, or cut through. In Tamil, a device that could do the same is called Kiripan. The demo would reveal it. Hence, Kiripan of Tamil distorted to Kirpan over a long passage of time. Hence, Kirpan evolved from Tamil Kiripan. Kanga. Before explaining Kanga, we shall explain how the English word balcony evolved from Tamil. This has relevance to Kanga. In Tamil, Kan means eye. In Tamil, a hole which is used to see through is also called Kan. Not only that, even a bridge with holes for water flow, say 5 holes, is called Anjikannu Palam. Palam in Tamil means bridge. Hence, not only eyes, even the holes are called Kan in Tamil. What you see here is the picture of a balcony. Here, there are a number of holes. In those days, the queen would sit in the balcony and watch the proceedings in the court, etc. Since the balcony had many holes to see through, it was called Palakanni or Palakani in Tamil. Here, Pala in Tamil means many and Kanni in Tamil means hole. The meaning of Palakani in Tamil means many holes. This Palakani was absorbed into English and was called Balcony. Palakani of Tamil became Balcony of English. Now we shall return to Kanga. Kanga is actually a comb for Sikhs. It used to be kept inserted near the top knot of the hair of the Sikhs. The Sikhs should clean their hair twice every day. Philosophically, the Kanga represents the pursuit of purity of Sikhs. It represents that the thoughts and actions of Sikhs should be pure. Since a comb is used to remove impurities and entanglings in hair, it is seen as a symbol of purity. But our assignment is to prove that Kanga is a word of Tamil origin. While conducting the etymology of balcony, which is a word of Tamil origin, we have introduced the fact that Kan means opening or a hole, apart from the standard meaning of eye in Tamil. The Sikhs use wooden comb. Such comb is produced by sawing out the unwanted wood to create many openings. Many openings in Tamil would be called Kangal, which is a plural form of Kan. It is this word Kangal which was used to call comb in the bygone era. This Kangal, over a period of time, got distorted to Kanga. Kanga is one of the words used to call comb in Tamil, but a popular word for the same is Sipu in Tamil, derived from the word Sikkam meaning hair. Kesh. Untrimmed hair is one of the 5 symbols of Sikhs. Since hair is called Kesh, Kesh is a symbol of Sikh faith. Philosophically, Kesh symbolizes the spirituality of the baptized Sikh. With our present knowledge, Kesh does not seem to be a word of Tamil origin. Thus, of the 5 symbols, 4 are of Tamil origin. Hence, we have sufficient proof to state that the Sikhs were originally Tamil people, and because of mingling of so many languages of the invaders, the Sikhs lost their original language, Tamil. The Sikhs are a disciplined community. They ought to be free from any lust for woman, money or power. They are defenders of common people, truth and liberty. Remember the attacks on P. Chidambaram, Sukram and Sarat Pawar by Sikhs. However, Mr. Manmohan Singh, a Sikh, had been a mute spectator when India helped Sri Lanka committing a genocide on Tamils of Sri Lanka. Even though he was in a position to stop the atrocity, he welcomed the offender Rajapaksa. Thus, he is violating the tenets of Sikhism because of his lust for power. Because of his lust for power, he lost his self-dignity too. To boost the political image of Rajiv Gandhi and Congress, 3,000 Sikhs were massacred in Delhi by the Congress goons.
मेरा नहीं हो सकता। RSS. Each morning across India, more than a million members of the RSS engage in physical exercises. They have a history of sectarian violence. In 1947, when India was partitioned, the RSS killed hundreds of thousands of fleeing Muslims.
Isn't it an irony that it is the same Congress, headed by none other than a Sikh, that helped the Sinhalese to destroy the liberty and life of Tamililam people?
Images are both disturbing and chilling. It ended 18 months ago, but the memories of a war filled with brutality and death haven't faded with time. It's claimed these were taken in the final days of the conflict. They show various scenes of horror, mounds of bodies on the back of a farm trailer, another line of dead, including what is believed to be the body of the son of the Tamil Tigers leader, Prabhakaran. They could be just scenes of mopping up the dead after the army's victory last May. They could be the scene of a war crime. Some pictures appear more sinister. These show bodies, possibly, of Tamil Tiger fighters, blindfolded, their hands bound, one lying in a shallow grave. It appears as if they were killed execution style. Many scenes are too graphic to show.
They are cruel and they are inhuman and they have committed the worst of crimes in history. It was a long genocide of 60 years.
It's not possible to verify the authenticity of the images. They were obtained by Al Jazeera from Tamil contacts, who said the photos were handed over by someone in the Sri Lankan military.
These photos provide compelling reasons for why there should be an international independent investigation into what happened in the final months of the conflict.
The Sri Lankan government has rejected the photographs, saying they are not genuine. It has always denied allegations of war crimes and promised to take action if it finds evidence. However, they have refused all international calls for an independent inquiry. Instead, Sri Lanka has set up its own inquiry called the Lessons Learnt and Reconciliation Commission. Critics say it's a whitewash. Last year, controversial videos surfaced allegedly showing Sri Lankan soldiers executing Tamil Tiger fighters. The UN special rapporteur at the time said he believed the video was authentic. At one stage, 300,000 displaced Tamils languished in makeshift camps. According to the latest figures, there are still 35,000 left. Emergency powers are still in force. There is still a heavy military presence in Tamil areas, and more are leaving the country. It may be some time before we learn the truth and the real lessons of this damaging conflict. Tony Birtley, Al Jazeera.
The Sikh community should introspect. A true Sikh, Uttam Singh, delivered justice for the Jallianwala Bagh massacre even after a lapse of 25 long years. Rajiv Gandhi did a similar thing in Elam, what Governor Tyre did at Jallianwala Bagh. Dear Indians, think of it and stand with truth, because ultimately only truth would prevail.